Welcome to the Outlook Getting Started video. In this video, I'm going to talk more about the library. The library tab contains two panels. First, we have to open the library. The left panel is the navigation panel that provides the possibility to select a location in which procedures, data, or schedule files are located. The panel on the right hand side lists the available procedures, data, or schedule files for the selected location. Four locations are always visible in the navigation panel. The default procedures. This location provides all the factory default procedures installed with Nova. These procedures cannot be deleted or modified. They can be loaded and modified in a procedure editor and saved as a new procedure. So for example, we have cyclic voltammetry, linear sweep voltammetry, voltammetric analysis, chronomethods, potentiometric stripping analysis, and impedance spectroscopy. If we go to cyclic voltammetry, select cyclic voltammetry potentiostatic, the procedure is opened and we can modify the parameters for the CV staircase. For example, I can change the upper vertex potentials to 2 volts and minus 2 volts. I can save it in a different name. Let's say CV modified. And now I can save this. Save modified. Now it's saved. But you won't see it in the default procedures. It will be stored in my procedures. CV modified. With the right mouse click, you can show where it is in your location. So it is in Documents, Nova 2.1, Procedures, CV Modified. In my procedures, this location contains all the user-defined procedures. This location maps all the procedures files located in my Documents, Nova 2.1, and Procedures folders. The My Data is the location contains all the user-generated data files. This location maps all the data files located in the My Documents Nova 2.1 data folder. So right mouse click on a file, for example, show in Windows Explorer. This file is in this location. And the same counts for My Schedules. The My Schedules is the location contains all the user generated schedules. This location maps all the schedule files located in the My Documents Nova 2.1 Schedule folder. The default procedures location is always visible in the library panel. This location contains a series of factory default procedures. These procedures are intended to perform simple measurements and can be used for routine experiments or as a template for more elaborate procedures. These procedures are provided as a read-only examples. They cannot be deleted or modified, but it is possible to open these procedures and to save them as a modified version in one of the user accessible locations. We can also add a location. It's possible to add one or more locations for either procedures, data, or schedules by clicking the plus button and selecting the required type of location, procedure, data, or schedule from the pop-out menu. A Windows folder selection window will be displayed. Using this control, it's possible to navigate to a folder to be added to the list of locations. For example, I can create a new folder for procedures and I can say, okay, I want to put them under a procedure tab, or I can create a new folder, let's say modified procedures, enter, and I select that folder. And it will be available underneath my procedure tab. At the moment, my procedures is the default location where we store the procedures, but with the right mouse clicking button, we can make the modified procedures as the default location. And now it's underlined. You see, it changes the underlined version from my procedures to modified procedures. When more than one location is specified in the library, one of these locations will be used as a default save location. This will be used to save procedures and data unless otherwise specified. By default, the My Procedures, My Data and My Schedules locations are used. It's possible to assign another location as the default save location by selecting it in the library panel and the right-clicking it. The context menu can be used to set the selected location as the new default location. You can also load from library. It's possible to open at any time in the library by double-clicking the corresponding entry in the panel on the right-hand side. So for example, if you go to data, you can just have a preview of what it is, and when double-clicking on it, it will show you the complete data set. The difference between data and procedure is data has the word data in the file, and also the command tiles are light green. Procedures, for example, don't contain data and only has the command tiles in a sequence. So this is the difference between a procedure and the data. You can also rating and tagging the data. For example, if you have good data and you want to tag it, for example, you can say, okay, I want to add 5 stars to the data. But also you can say, I want to add a tag, let's say good impedance to it. You can tag it with any type of name you want to define. So it's possible to directly edit the rating and tags for items in the library. To specify the rating of an entry in the library, click the highest star in the rating field. It's also possible to edit the tags for a library item. To add a tag, click the Add button and specify a tag to add to the item. A pop-out field will be displayed, allowing specifications of a text used for tagging the data or procedure item in the library. It is possible to remove the tag by clicking the X next to the tag. For example, this one and this one. The library provides the option to quickly locate the file on the computer. Right-click on the item in the library displays a context menu that provides the choice to show the windows in Explorer. Using this option, a Windows Explorer window will be opened, showing the location of the file matching the selected item. For example, this one, show Windows Explorer, and that's this folder. This file is mentioned. And you can copy this to any location on your computer. You can also delete files from the library. Through the library interface, it's possible to delete one or more files from a location. To delete a file from an active location, click the minus button, for example this one, and then it will pop-up menu will show, are you sure you want to delete FRA impedance potential static? When you press yes, to delete the file. Deleting a file from the library also deletes the source file from the computer. The file is moved to the recycle bin, and if needed, it can be restored if possible. For more information on the library, you will find the user manual under chapter number 6. Thank you for watching Getting Started video.